All right, hello everyone. My name is Max with Strength Surge, and today I have an informative video for you. If you are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I regularly post informative videos and give tips, tricks, and secrets on training, and I also post kind of my own training stuff. Anyways, the topic of today's video is how to gain muscle and strength as fast as possible. And I will outline five basic principles or tips that I have used throughout my training journey that I have found to be more than effective. And I would stick around till the end of the video where I give what I think is the most important training tip of all. And I'll also kind of go over what I did in my first year of training and the kind of progress I saw, which in my opinion was pretty substantial. And this information, it's mainly going to concern beginners and intermediates because advanced trainees already know these things. That's why they're advanced. Let's begin. So tip number one is to eat in a caloric surplus. So what is eating in a caloric surplus? Eating in a caloric surplus simply means eating more calories every day than you need to maintain your current body weight. So, for example, if you need 3,000 calories a day to maintain a body weight of 190 pounds, if you're eating anything over 3,000 calories, you would be in a surplus of calories. And generally, I recommend first finding your maintenance calories, which would be your calorie goal per day, the amount of calories it takes to maintain your body weight. I will link a calorie calculator in the description of this video, which makes it relatively simple to do this. This is what I do. Once you've found your maintenance calorie needs, I would slowly start to add calories. So I would add 200 to 300 calories a day, and this would equal 1,400 to 2,100 extra calories a week, which actually seems like a significant amount of calories. Some might think this approach is too conservative. In my opinion, it doesn't take much to gain weight, and you're much better slowly adding calories rather than throwing a bunch of bulk, because if you throw in a bunch of calories, the chance of adding fat and not muscle is extremely high. So that is why I recommend that approach. And at the end of the video, I will discuss my personal experience, my approach I took in my first year of training to add calories. And eating in a caloric surplus will make it much easier to add muscle mass and gain strength, because you're giving your body an excess of calories, which when it doesn't have an excess, there's other functions in the body that are much more important to it than gaining muscle and strength. Okay, tip number two is eat an adequate amount of protein daily. So eating an adequate amount of protein daily will give your body the building blocks to actually build muscle and therefore build strength. Now, what is adequate? Different people have different interpretations of this. There's a million different answers. This is what I would. I think you should eat anywhere from 0.8 to 1.5 grams per pound of body weight, which would be 0.36 to 0.68 grams per kilo. I believe this is sufficient. And if you are at the lower end of the spectrum, I think you should be fine, especially if you're a beginner. Your body's going to want to put on strength and mass no matter what. It's not something I would worry too much about, but be mindful of doing this. If you need to, I would purchase protein powder or a protein drink supplement, something like that. I personally shoot for 1 to 1.5 grams of protein per pound of body weight a day, and I do take a protein supplement. I will post an affiliate link in the description for the two protein sources I commonly use. Excuse me. Tip number three is progressively overload your muscles. So what is progressive overload? That might be something, a term you've heard before, but might not know what it is. So progressive overload simply means exposing your body to a greater stress than is normal in order to facilitate an adaptive response. So you need your body to adapt, which would mean gaining more muscle and getting stronger in order to basically defend against this novel stimulus. So for example, if you're bench pressing 135 pounds for 5 sets of 5, workout one, progressive overload could be bench pressing 140 pounds for 5 sets of 5, workout two. So this would be linear progression, a linear progressive overload, which that actually has more to do with periodization and is a topic I could discuss in another video if anyone is interested. I will not go too in depth on that right now, so comment below if that is something you are more interested in learning about. periodization and actually how you should be moving weight or overall volume week to week. And that brings me into progressive overload requires an increase in training volume. So traditionally volume would be weight on the bar times sets times reps. And so back to our first example, workout one would have a total training volume of 3,375 pounds. And then workout two would have a overall training volume of 3,500 pounds. So you see this obvious increase in training volume. That would be 125 pounds of extra training volume. So there are a number of different ways to increase training volume, adding weight to the bar, adding reps, adding sets, etc. I will not go into this right now. It's something I could discuss in another video if anyone is interested. So comment below if that's something you would like me to talk about. And then to make this easy, to make progressive overload easy, I recommend both beginners and intermediates just jumping on a pre-written program. There's a number of free strength and bodybuilding type programs out there. I will link a page on Reddit with a bunch of these in the description below, which I think is pretty useful. I would also be willing to help you if you're interested. There's a link to my Instagram on my YouTube channel page. Feel free to send me a message and I'll see if I could help you out a little bit. I'd love to. I like doing all things training, so let me know. Tip number four is primarily utilize compound movements for a majority of your training. So again, what is a compound movement? Compound movement is a multi-joint movement that uses several muscles or muscle groups at one time. So this would be squat, bench, deadlift, overhead press, bent over row, etc. Your big movements where you can use a lot of weight. So compound movements should comprise of roughly, in my opinion, 75 to 90% of your overall training volume. This is the big bang for your buck, the meat and potatoes. This is where you're gonna pack on a bunch of mass because you're using all these different muscle groups in one exercise. You know, it's pretty, makes sense, right? That's common sense. Like, do these exercises because they use more muscles. Isolation exercises, on the other hand, are movements that require only one muscle, or, you know, basically try to target one specific muscle. You know, bodybuilding movements, it'd be like a curl, a lateral raise, a tricep pushdown, something like that. These movements are not nearly as effective at putting on overall mass, and it should probably make up 10 to 25% of your overall training volume, in my opinion. And balance is the key to creating an effective program, and individual goals are going to affect how this balance is between compound and isolation movements, which, if that's something you're interested in, creating an effective training program, let me know. I could do a video on that. Comment below. Just basic programming. So tip number five, this is what everyone's been waiting for. This is the big secret. And there's really nothing groundbreaking about this. It's actually quite simple, but it's very overlooked. And it's, again, the simple things are the things that work, and it's not what people want to do because it's so simple and that's all you gotta do. So tip number five is just be consistent, be compliant with all of these principles. I outlined these four principles above for an extended period of time. Like, if you can be disciplined and work hard to apply these above principles for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, a year, many years, you will get so big and strong relative to your genetic potential and what you can achieve. You're not even gonna know what to do with yourself, I'm telling you. It's really that simple. Like, it's just like, execute this over a long period of time and just do your best to make it as optimal as possible. It's like, it's crazy. I mean, that's pretty much anything in life, right? That's just how it is. And you know, this is big picture stuff. You don't have to pay attention too much to all these small details. Like, it's just, the small details are not nearly as important. And for the last 6 years, this is what I've been trying to do. I've been trying to apply these five principles, and you know, I put on a good amount of mass. I'm like 235, 240 right now. I don't know what percent, maybe 15% body fat, I have no idea. I'm a natural lifter, and you know, I'm pretty strong. I've squatted 495, benched 325, deadlifted 585, so those are pretty good numbers, you know. Not elite, but and I, you know, I haven't even been perfect by any means, you know. I've done a lot of things wrong. I've made a lot of mistakes, but the bottom line is if you do this to the best of your ability, you're gonna do great things. this video is running kind of long. I'll try to finish real quick, but in my first year of training, I put on 25 to 30 pounds of muscle, or I wouldn't say muscle, of quality size. Obviously, there was some fat. I was probably at a similar body fat percentage at that time. This is kind of where I like to sit. And I was eating anywhere from 3,000 to 3,500 calories a day. I probably went from around 180 to 210 pounds. So I was eating in a pretty big surplus, but I was also working out pretty hard. And this just goes to show, you know, small details. I was eating Panda Express twice a day, every day. Those were my two meals, Panda Express. And then I would drink a mass gainer at night sometimes. And I was hitting my caloric needs. I was getting a hell of a lot of sodium. And like I said, the big picture is more important than what you're actually, you know, the small stuff. It's like, do the big picture stuff and you'll make great progress. So yes, it's really that simple, guys. Like, it's a matter of outlining a general plan with these big picture items and just doing that for an extended period of time. Like, I don't think I could make it any simpler than that. You know, in the comment section below, let me know what you think of this. Let me know if you would like me to expand on any of these details a little more, you know. I like making these videos. I like talking about this kind of stuff. It's what I like to do. So, yeah, you know, anything you could think of. If you like this video, smash that like button. It would really help me out to grow the channel and just get more exposure. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. I come out with, you know, probably, I don't know, 3 or 4 videos a week or something, some training related, some more information related. And I really hope this helps, guys. Again, this is something I see in the gym, just people spinning their wheels. And again, it's really this simple. It's just like, do the above 5 things and you'll become a big, strong person, you know? I appreciate all the support. I really hope this helps. Thank you, everyone, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks. Bye.